Hey guys, it's Nastia. Welcome back to my channel. Today, our first special guest. This is my neighbor, Alex, and we're having a fireside chat. I know you can't see the fire, but it's on. So here we go. I'm gonna take you guys back
to the beginning.
First of all, I've never had a neighbor friend.
Me, well, not my age. I had like an 80-year-old once when I was a kid.
Oh, okay.
And she bought cookie dough for me for like a school thing.
All right. I was gonna say, I feel like now I have competition.
She's probably not alive.
Long story short, I moved in to this neighborhood. Met a few people on the block, and everyone's like, oh, have you met Alex? And I'm like, yeah. Who's Alex? And also just Alex, like, so not sure, is it like the
boy,
new cute
girl.
Guy? I'm like, oh, do I need to meet him? Or is it a new best friend? Like,
you were hoping for the guy.
I mean, it's okay. I'm just kidding. And then multiple people told me, so then. Literally, I think it was the first day. It was the second day. Boxes had just arrived from LA, so I didn't have any clothes or any shoes, and finally my boxes came. I went to take the trash out.
Yeah.
Opened a box to grab a pair of shoes. This is where it almost went downhill.
Yeah, I was judging hard because I meet Miss Nastia Liukin with Fendi slippers on in her driveway. And I was
taking out trash.
And I think it was like one of those juicy couture
sets.
No, I'm pretty sure it was juicy from like circa 2003, which props being able to fit into your 2003 clothes. But she was in a full juicy like sweatsuit matching set. Said juicy on the butt. It was great with her Fendi slippers.
Okay, Fendi slippers, correct. To be fair, I did not dig through the box to find my fit. Fuzzy Fendi slippers to take out the trash. That being said, they were on top. Grabbed the first pair of shoes. So I'm looking, you know, like you do when you're moving into a house, like not cute with Fendi slippers on, and walk out, and right in front of me, this lovely couple.
Yeah, so the flip side is I went on a walk with my husband. We're walking back to the house. One of our neighbors.
Hi, Jordan.
Hi.
So we were walking back, and one of our neighbors was like, oh my God, the new girl just moved in. And I was like, oh, that's great. You know, expecting. So the average age of our neighborhood is probably 60. And there's 18 homes, and so I was like, cool, like another like friend from my mom. And so we were kind of walking up, and she said, you know, she's an athlete. And I was like, an athlete? I was like, all right. And she goes, and she's from Plano. And I was like, an athlete from Plano? I was like, okay, cool, like whatever. And so we were walking, and she goes, and she has some weird Ukrainian name. And I was like, all right. And so we're walking, and all of a sudden I turned to Jordan. I was like, I think it's Nastia Liukin is my neighbor. And he was like, I don't know who that is. And I was like, whatever.
He thought I was going to be a tall basketball player.
Yeah.
So then,
yeah,
like,
so he was
here
very
I am
confused.
My Fendi slipper.
Yeah, so we walked by, and you were outside in your juicy outfit. It was really sweet. And my first impression of you was just how talkative you were. Yeah.
Is that a... bad?
No, it's not bad. Okay. No, it's not bad. But like, I'm a naturally very talkative person.
Oh yeah, you are. I was going to say, you.
And so I usually do like the 90-10, like 90% of the conversation's me, 10% is the other person. And we talked to you for like 45 minutes.
My mom was actually
here.
She came out at one point. She was just like, is everything good, basically?
Yeah, like, who are these people? And so we leave, and Jordan.
No, I asked for your number.
Oh yeah, you got my number. That's very forward.
Cut to the chase.
And then and like we were walking away, and Jordan was like, wow, she talks to you. And so I was like, this is cool. And I was like really excited. And what you probably don't know is I called my best friend, and I was like, oh my God, an Olympian's living next door to me. And she like totally freaked out, which now you've met her, so it's like not weird.
No,
but
it's funny.
And I called my parents, obviously, because we're all Olympic fans, and their first thing that they told me was, well, don't get your hopes up if she doesn't want to be your friend. Probably very busy and
also,
very cool.
Love your mom and dad if you guys are watching.
Yeah, hi. They'll watch. And I put on lipstick for my mom because yes. I knew I would hear that.
I got a spray tan for her.
Yeah, there you go. My mom is former pageant queen, very like lovely. And so, anyway, they all warned me not to get my hopes up. This probably wouldn't be my like newest friend, but it would be fun to like brag
have,
about.
And have someone your age,
right,
in the neighborhood,
or if I needed
love
something.
Love our other neighbors.
Anyway, so we.
So we've really just gotten to know each other because it's quarantine.
Yeah, we are. I guess we should say this because of COVID. We are quarantining together.
Yeah, it's been since I moved in, basically.
Yeah, I think the newest neighbors that just moved in, I think got the impression that you live with me and Jordan.
Okay, because...
Or Jordan and I don't know.
We're all roommates, basically, they thought.
Yeah, they thought, and we didn't correct her. So we're like, whatever, she's cool.
Well, because you're like, hi, I'm Alex and Jordan, here's a bottle of wine. I'm like, and I'm
and here's my brownies.
To be fair, I wasn't going over it. And you were like, just come by, like... it's fine.
Come meet
like,
the neighborhood that it's offered
like, no.
for you to go by
I'm
yourself.
Not going, and I'm not going empty-handed. I don't have anything.
And
you're like, just
I made
say
brownies,
that these brownies
and wine. Yeah, so anyway, I guess then the first thing I was like, well, should I invite her to do something? And Jordan was like, yeah, just have her go on a walk with you because of quarantine and all that, like, so you could be socially distant. I was like, yeah, cool. Like, girls in their early 30s love to go for walks, you know, whatever. So I asked her, I was like, hey, do you want to go on a walk with me? And she's like, yeah, sure. And she seemed really into it.
Meanwhile, I'm texting my best friend, Jenny, and I'm like, she just asked me to go on a walk. I don't go on walks. I hate walking. I feel like it's a waste of time. I also didn't have Harley then, so
yeah,
I wasn't
Yeah, there wasn't like a need for a walk.
My whole thing with walking
is... You don't like to be outside working out.
No. I don't mind outside.
You don't
it's
like
if I'm spending 45 minutes doing something active, I want to feel like I'm getting in like a workout. So if had you said like, hey, come.
We'll do lunges. Like come do lunges with me.
I don't know. We're like, not that like workout classes are like a thing. I don't know. Like I just feel like it's a waste of time.
The problem is now all we do is we sit around and eat food. So
yes,
I think a walk would be at least better.
Long story short, got the biggest blister of my entire life, like this big on the back of my heel. I was bleeding. I was limping.
She was limping into the neighborhood. This is going on too long, but she was limping into the neighborhood and I felt like kind of bad, but then like kind of good about myself, like proud, like, oh, I kind of dominated this Olympian on this walk. And so I get home and I like call my parents because of course they want to know like how did your walk with her
and
go?
What is she like?
And what is she like? And I told her, I was like, well, I feel bad. She got like a really bad blister. And my dad, like this is part of, we'll get into this, but I'm an only child as well. And so my parents, like if you told them Nastia Liukin and Alex McGowan are the same level of athlete, like they would think nothing of that. And so my dad's comment to me was, so let me get this straight, you beat her on the walk. And I was like, yeah. And he's like, all right, this is good. And I was like, all right.
And now we've never walked again. And we're basically best friends. And who has a cool best friend neighbor? Anyways, that's probably been the best part of quarantine.
For sure.
It's been a weird year. We've personally gone through a lot. And this has been great. So we thought it would be fun to have a little fireside chat, and Alex has some questions for me.
She has not seen these.
Also, I think like in starting this, and like we've talked a lot about this, and like the people that know me are like, this is great. People will finally get to know the real you. People still think that like a lot of what we've been posting is not the real me. This is really, really the real me.
Yeah, because I am probably, okay, so I looked today because I thought this would be good to know. I have 270-ish Instagram followers. So I'm the most real person in her life, probably. that's one of my questions, honestly, later, is to how do I increase my following? But we'll get
to we're going there.
Okay, so I'm going to ask questions that I would have wanted to know as a normal Joe living next to you.
That beat me on a walk. Let's go.
Okay, cool. All right, please say your full name and how you should pronounce it to be accurate.
Okay, great question.
Yeah.
So... Are these rapid, like...
Yeah, we're doing this. Okay, so if you've ever seen the 73 questions on YouTube.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're a very long-winded person. Let's keep this to one or two sentences.
Oh, okay. Cut to the chase.
Yeah.
Anastasia Liukina.
Okay, so honest to see ya.
So this is how I explain it. It's Anastasia. This can't be a one-sentence thing.
You can't.
Anastasia, but that in Russian, it's Anastasia. But a lot of people can't say the accent. So I explained it to Alex and Jordan that it's honest to see ya.
Yeah.
Anastasia.
And now Jordan solely calls you that.
Yes.
Do you have another nickname other than Nastia?
I don't.
Okay, that's kind of lame. Okay.
Do you?
My next question was like, would you tell the version of the day we met? We already went through that. We already talked about this. Only children here. I think that's why we get along so well. We are the light of our parents' lives, okay?
And
that
we
is
love
the best
them
way to describe
so
that.
So much.
So this is a good question because this is a difference between me and you. How many times a day do you FaceTime one of your parents?
My mom.
Either one.
My dad is not big on his phone.
Okay.
Is yours?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
But we never FaceTime.
Yeah, we don't FaceTime. Oh, if my dad's FaceTiming me or calling me, I'm like, what's wrong?
Something's wrong.
Yeah.
Okay.
My mom, if I don't get a FaceTime from her at least once, something's wrong.
Yeah, but it's
so
it's
on average 3 to 5.
Okay, now taking that step farther, grandparents, how many times do you FaceTime them in a day?
At least once a day.
Okay. And they always FaceTime, which is super weird because you guys live within like 10 miles of each other.
But it didn't matter if we lived halfway across the world or 10 miles.
It's just weird.
It's FaceTime.
I'm just telling you it's weird.
No, but what I'm saying is it's consistent.
Maybe it's a foreign thing because the other people I know that are from different countries.
No, I think, maybe. Jenny and I FaceTime all the time. She's Korean.
That's what I'm saying.
But I don't think she FaceTimes
people. I don't know. I don't FaceTime people. Okay. Okay, so you speak Russian. Do you speak any other languages?
Took Spanish in high school.
Okay, that doesn't count. All right, here's my next question. It's post or pre-COVID. You're having a dinner party here at your house. 3 people you would invite, not including your lovely parents, dead or alive.
Okay, so does this include, like, you?
No.
Use
this for more interesting people, like, that you don't know.
Okay. Oh, but I can know them, maybe.
You can know them, but like that's too easy.
Oh. Okay. I would say Jennifer Aniston.
Ooh, good.
I think, like, love friends, just like...
Just like what?
Just
yes.
Cool.
Explain.
Just love her.
Yeah, okay.
Funny and cool.
Okay.
Someone that could sing very... Taylor Swift, maybe?
Yes.
Entertainment. You need
entertainment
at a dinner
party.
Okay,
yeah, she can eat and sing.
And then I guess a guy. Like, someone
like an eligible bachelor?
Like, yeah, an eligible bachelor.
Shoot, I don't know who those people are right now. I feel like all of Hollywood is, like, taken right now.
Quarantine things.
I know. Okay. That's a good start. All right, going to your childhood, most embarrassing moment of your life. Could be childhood, could be adulthood.
Third grade. It was either second, third, or fourth. I'm really hoping it wasn't fourth because...
Did you pee your pants?
Yeah, because my teacher wouldn't let me go to the bathroom.
Yeah, I did that in fourth.
And then someone looked over and said, Miss, I forget who, the chair's leaking. And I was like... And then I started crying.
That's really bad.
Yeah.
But
who doesn't let someone go to the bathroom?
That's bad.
Yeah.
That's bad. Speaking of favorite teachers, that was my next one. Who is your favorite teacher that you remember?
My first grade teacher, Mrs. Tony.
Okay, good. Shout out.
Shout out.
If you were a teacher, what subject would you teach? Or would you, like, want to teach the little kids? Or would you want to teach, like, high school math?
Okay, so I feel like little... No, not high school math. I feel like little kids, it's a lot of pressure because, like, I know, like, your parents have to teach you, like, the fundamentals of life.
Right.
But also, like, teaching first, like, spelling, like, that kind of stuff is stuff you remember. And
yeah, that's, like, actually stuff
so I would like to, like, teach, like, something, like, art.
Okay.
Like,
an artist.
No, I'm not an artist. But, like, or an elective, essentially.
Okay. All right. Okay.
Yeah.
That's good. Were you allowed to watch TV as a child?
Yes, I was allowed, but like what kind of TV?
Like, we've talked about this. Very strict parents, very strict, like no PG-13 movies. Yeah. But like, yeah, so you watch Rugrats.
Rugrats, Hey Arnold, yes, Tom and Jerry. Dog. Oh, Cat Dog was weird to me.
Were you Saved by the Bell fan?
No.
Shoot. I was not allowed to watch Friends as a child.
No, I didn't watch Friends till like high school.
Yeah. Okay. These next three are because you're a child of the 90s. Were you a fan of Limited 2?
Are you kidding?
And what was your favorite thing to buy there?
Anything that said gymnast. Gymnast.
Okay.
Gymnast.
Okay, cool. I bought that stuff too. Did you get your ears pierced at Claire's?
Yes, duh. Okay, and they're good. Still uneven.
Still uneven. Did you own a Tamagotchi and did you make your parents take care of it when you were busy?
Of course. It was clear with blue buttons, but it was a nano baby.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because we weren't allowed to take them to school, so they had to take care of them when I was at school.
Right.
Okay,
clean up the poop and stuff.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Okay, gymnastics and career questions. These are very serious. Where are your gold medals right now?
I have one.
Oh. Well, all your medals, whatever.
Oh, I was about to say in a safe, but they're actually in my kitchen cabinet here with Harley's dog treats.
Okay, so for the record, when people ask me, okay, so you're Nastia's friend, blah, 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 like, two questions I always get. A, what does she wear to your house?
Everyone thinks
she dresses literally homeless when she comes to my house.
All the time. People are like, do you own anything under $100?
Yeah, everything she wears to my house. And it's like, has holes in it. I don't, like, she needs new clothes, honestly. And like very like always sweatshirts and sweatpants.
My
house is cold.
Like biker shorts.
Question people always ask me is, have I seen your Olympic medals? And until like 4 days ago, 4 business days ago, I had not seen them.
I had to bring them over here for something I was doing. Yeah. And
then most people ask me, did you try them on? And I was like, no way. That's like trying on someone's engagement ring. That's like taboo.
That too. Yeah, I have never been one to try on anyone else's medals. Like never
but
tried my dad.
Have.
But people have. It doesn't bother me. Okay. But I'm a little bit more with you from like someone else's perspective.
Here's
right?
my deal. Like if I always heard if you try someone's engagement ring on, you're never gonna be engaged. But that's an old wives' tale. I'm not saying that. But then I just feel like, why would I hang up my chance of winning an Olympic gold medal? I'm only 30. There's still time.
Okay.
Why would I jinx that?
See, I'm with you.
Right?
So don't ever try.
Yeah. So that's okay. And that's part of the next question is, and you kind of answered this, if I wore your gold medals for like a Halloween costume, like would that bother you?
No. I had an ex that did that and, I was not bothered. I thought it was funny.
But you guys broke up, so maybe it's bad luck.
I guess so. Maybe it is bad luck. Like, no matter what. Like,
yeah, maybe just don't
touch. You can touch, but like,
you
don't.
You can touch, but don't. I took a picture of him. Okay, personally, I think being on Gossip Girl was one of your greatest accomplishments. Do you agree? And why?
100%. I read all the books. I was like not a bandwagon fan. I was a real fan. Read all the books, and then it became a TV show, and I was just like, oh my gosh. And
yeah, so you pulled some strings to get yourself on there.
I didn't.
Oh, you were asked.
Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty big.
Producers of the show were sitting next to me at a restaurant. They sent over a little note with the waiter that said,
ooh,
congrats on the gold. Keep watching Gossip Girl XOXO.
Ooh. All red in a Kristen Bell voice, I'm
with
sure.
Lipstick.
What was your line in Gossip Girl? Do you remember? You have one line, right? She can't even do it.
Are you Chuck Bass? Are you Blair's girl? And then she goes, shoot.
Are you Chuck Bass?
Are you Blair's girl? Not bad. You know, the roof has a spectacular view of the city.
Oh. Excuse me, he's taking Chew.
You look lovely.
Okay, she's great. Love her.
Love them all. Love
okay, I read your wiki page today to like just,
don't
I don't
believe
know.
Everything you read.
Okay, American Ninja Warrior or Dancing with the Stars, which one were you more nervous for? Now, I know you did get into the stretch over and over and over.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I would say dancing for sure. I don't like to dance. Like, well, rewind. I loved Dancing with the Stars. I love learning, like, choreographed dance.
Sure.
I'm not, like, on the dance floor at a wedding, like, in the middle
busting
of the... Yeah, that's... It's just not for me.
So being in front of a crowd.
Yeah, so that was kind of, like, I guess it was, like, more dances that I didn't... Like, the Argentine tango, loved it. It was more, like, fierce and, like, very gymnastics-y.
Yeah.
But, like, the samba... Like, not no, like, okay, anyways. So, yeah, I would say...
They had a great partner.
Yes.
Derek
was great. One of my favorite things, like, besides, like, the dances and learning, it was, like, the costumes. And, like, being able to basically portray a different character every week
That's cool.
And, like, you got to do it by... Because, like, in gymnastics, you're always playing yourself, you know?
Right, it's just you
and all, obviously in life. But the costumes and the hair and makeup, like, you could really get into, like, your character. And I thought that was cool.
That's cool.
Ninja, I was nervous about. But I also, mostly because I've had other, I don't have any other girl. Oh, Chelsea did it this year. We've had other guy gymnasts do it, and they've done very well.
Well, I feel like it's very in tune with what you guys
yes.
do.
Yes, and so, but that was the thing. It was like, oh,
so
gymnasts are really good. And I'm
yeah,
like,
so the pressure.
Yeah, maybe like in my, you know, when I was
sure,
like,
sure,
but
sure.
I, when I got the opportunity to do it, I was like, this is a perfect, like, time for me to be like, okay, you should start, like, working out more seriously.
No, that's good.
And I did not. And all of a sudden, it was like.
Game time.
Tomorrow.
Oh, that's
And I was
scary.
Like. Gonna cross my fingers here and
but you made it.
Yeah, it was great.
That's
it was
cool.
Good cause. So.
Okay, good. All right, if you had to choose another sport to do in the Olympics, which one would you choose?
Figure skating, except I hate the cold.
Yeah, okay.
But I loved their costumes and
yeah.
I loved how they had skirts.
Okay, like, let me ask you a question. So, for the viewers, I was a very serious gymnast through level 7. Which is, you know, very elite, obviously.
I have seen your floor routine.
Sometimes when I have a little glass of wine, I can, like, bust it out. But once my mom bought me a figure skating leotard
for gymnastics,
and I had that cute little skirt.
And they
and
said,
I thought
wow.
I was the prettiest girl in the gymnastics.
Oh, they let you wear it?
Yeah.
In level 7?
No.
Oh,
this
oh,
was,
like
early
classes.
On.
Okay,
yeah.
I was going to say.
Like...
Well, I think,
level, whatever.
Yeah, I love
know.
That. I think, I just feel like it was more
it's
feminine.
It's so cute. And it, like, kind of, like, swishes. I don't know. I just felt very pretty.
Yeah, and
hard
I
hard to do bars with it.
I was going
to
say, it's a safety thing. It would get tangled and, like,
yeah, I didn't do anything that hard, you know, so.
But you had a good lower team.
Okay, pop culture.
Ooh.
If you could have any actress play you in a movie about your life, who would you have play you?
Blake Lively. Love her.
That's a good one.
She's very quick.
Have you met her?
No. So when I did Gossip Girl,
shoot.
I was so sad. Nothing against like
everyone
Claire and Chuck. Yeah.
Claire and Chuck, because that's their real names.
When I moved to New York, pre-New York, Sean and I, right after the Olympics, would sometimes pretend like we like have fake names. Like if we went to Starbucks together right after the Olympics. Blake, like I was
I
always obsessed with Blake Lively.
You know?
And
I get it.
And so Blake was always like one of my favorite. I don't know.
Oh.
So
she's very cool.
Yeah. She just seems cool. And I love like her family. Like,
and
just
I just
cool.
feel like she's friends with Taylor Swift, right? So if you're friends with her, then you might get invited to her dinner party, you know.
Just a great
the whole
group. Like they'd be great at
Okay, so this kind of
in the neighborhood.
Have you ever been starstruck by a celebrity, like meeting one?
Taylor Swift, I think.
Okay, so you met her.
Yeah, so nice. It's been years. Like
that's cool.
I think it was on her Fearless tour.
Shoot, I hate to admit this, but I've never been to a Taylor Swift concert.
What?
But I know all her songs by heart.
I'm
know.
Obsessed in not creepy way. I just love her. I love her music, but I also just.
She's cool.
Genius. Like,
yeah.
It, as a businesswoman, as...
Yeah.
And not that, like, life is all about business, but just...
No, she's
I
very
just,
cool.
Yeah, she's cool. And then, other than that, I love meeting other athletes just because I wouldn't necessarily say it's, like, a starstruck thing. We have, like, a commonality.
Sense.
Yeah, and, like,
yeah.
a mutual like we understand each other, but also like I could know nothing about this sport, and I love learning about other people's sports and like how they train or, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's cool.
Yeah, I would say Taylor Swift.
Okay, that's good. So I don't know if the viewers know this. Viewers, are viewers on YouTube? Is that what you call it?
Subscribers.
Well,
hopefully you have subscribers.
Okay, I know, and maybe not everyone knows this, but you do not watch any of The Real Housewives on Bravo.
That is accurate.
Okay, so do you feel like you're missing out? And also, you know, is there any regret around the decision not to watch?
You have now tried to get me to watch any city housewife.
Just any city, pick one.
No, I just...
I'm gonna be honest, I think it holds you back in friendships.
Oh, wow. Wow!
I just think...
You will never be...
I just think as a 30-year-old woman...
Also, don't say that again. It makes me feel very old. As a 30-year-old woman...
As a young lady, I just feel that it limits the conversation topics with other young ladies.
I don't think we have an issue having a topic of
conversation. You're my only friend that doesn't watch them.
Really?
And there are memes I would like to send you, and that, I just
okay,
can't.
That I,
like, and then like things
love...
that come up, it's just, I can't, you won't relate, and it's hard.
I get that.
Okay, so no
But
regret.
Also, I'm kind of like... If it didn't happen for me in 2020, where we had lots of time,
that's true.
Not sure it's gonna happen.
Okay, whatever.
Nothing
it's
against
a flaw,
it.
That's fine.
It's okay, I'll take that.
If you were to raid one woman's closet, whose closet would you raid? You have a great closet.
Oh, Hailey Bieber.
Ooh.
I like her style. I think it's very feminine.
She's like inner Diana sometimes.
That mixed with like very feminine, but then like sporty tomboy a little bit.
Yeah.
Like she rocks a good pair of like Jordans with like jeans and then like leather. Yeah, I like her style.
All right, I like that.
Between you, Jillian, and Jenny, the memes are out of control to the point where all three of you guys. Or on mute. No, you're all on mute on my Instagram.
That's pretty good.
Because I have my notifications on for DMs for only the people I follow.
Okay.
So the amount of like messages the three of us send to each other.
Okay. Is a lot.
Is a lot.
Can you do a group thing on Instagram?
I love you.
I know nothing. What did I call the little, I called him a button the other day. The stories. No, the
highlights.
Yes.
You called it
a button. I called it a button.
A button.
Yeah, I called it a button.
You're like, it's round. I'm like, okay.
My mom asked me the other day.
This is why this works.
What's the difference between the stories and a regular post? And I honestly couldn't answer it for her. I don't really get it.
24 hours. The story.
But why would you just post it?
Because you don't want it on your feed.
Oh, okay. I don't get it.
Alex has finally like understood when I'm trying to take like a picture or a video or like whatever. Not even that, like a story.
Yeah.
And I'm like, hold on, I gotta get the right filter.
My
lighting.
Food gets cold. It's like that whole
Jordan on the her sweet husband.
He works in marketing, so he gets it.
He gets it, but he's also like, are you done?
My
with
burger's that? Cold.
Yeah.
No, I don't get it. That's okay.
No,
it's fine.
Yeah, but you respect
I respect
it.
That it's part of your job. And what do I do? That's the question of the day. She doesn't know what I do. I work in finance.
No, fine. Yes, but...
It's okay. That's enough. Okay. Speaking of Instagram, going back to the original thing at the beginning, I have around 250 followers. Like
okay.
50, not 50,000. What could I do to gain more followers?
First of all, take yourself off private.
Never.
There you go.
I love feeling the power of, like, saying yes or no.
Oh, whoa.
It's like a power trip.
Interesting. And you like
so
to, like,
ridiculous.
Have options of who...
Let's like, be honest, though, I get maybe 3 requests a week. And
depending on when I tag you.
If you tag me, I get 3 in one day. But then nothing for the rest of the week.
I would say content is king.
Okay.
When was the last time you posted? Oh, actually, I take that back. You posted last week.
I did. What did I post?
You guys were fishing.
I was on a trip. Yeah. I post. See, I just don't think that's going to gain me followers in the women category as my fishing picture.
But, okay, then you have to decide who's your demo. So you want more women followers.
Yeah, I don't think men is the right answer since I'm married. I want a bunch of single 20-year-old men following me.
Next.
That'll be great. Okay, we're moving on. Okay, these are random questions. Have you ever been camping?
Yeah.
Did you like it?
No.
Would you go again?
Yeah.
Okay.
I really just like... No, next.
Okay.
I don't like going to the bathroom in the woods.
Have you done it?
Yeah.
Did you shake it off or did you shake paper?
Next question.
Favorite movie of all time?
I love Christmas. I love holiday movies. The Holiday, specifically, Cameron Diaz.
Oh, I've never seen it. I know. Wait, Jillian behind the camera is dying right now.
Dinner plans are over.
Yeah, we're going to dinner.
No, we're watching it this week.
Okay, let's watch it.
I'm not even kidding
you. I know, I just haven't seen it.
How?
My favorite one is The Christmas Vacation with Chevy Chase. So good. I know all the words. It's old though. Old. Yeah. That's gonna make everyone mad if I say that, but.
Well, not. It's a
it's
classic.
From like the '90s.
A classic. Maybe is better than old.
It's a little inappropriate. I would suggest watching it on the television where they bleep a little thing. Yeah.
Depending on who's watching this movie
yes.
right now.
Yeah.
I love a good Christmas movie. A rom-com. Like yeah, I'm okay. just and very like chick, flicky.
Okay.
I don't love action. First, okay. like I'm not a huge like.
Do you like suspense?
Mystery suspense.
Like Taken, Liam Neeson.
Yes, love that.
Okay,
but I. Don't...
I feel like Liam Neeson's like fatherly role is like very cool.
Yeah, yeah, I loved that. There was a few, too many though. I think.
Yeah, well, I actually like them all.
Oh.
Okay, if I were to drive you through a drive-thru restaurant right now, what would you order?
Fast food, I don't know what kind of place you're talking, but...
Okay, I pick you up in my car, I say, I'm gonna drive you through a drive-thru somewhere.
A hot date?
Yeah, and it's my treat.
Ooh! In-N-Out, a Shake Shack, like a burger. I would do a burger, but not... But I'm very particular with burgers. Like, In-N-Out or Shake Shack.
We did... What did we do for your B-Day? We did Shake Shack.
Shake Shack, yeah, with candles. So I would say, yeah. And fries.
Yes.
Always fries. This was a great question.
Thanks.
I'm like very not like surprised, but like those were really good.
I felt
questions.
Good about it.
Hopefully
I ran
you guys got to know.
I ran it by a couple Well, because you know.
Also I gave you like 2 seconds to put this together a day.
We talked about it yesterday. Yeah.
But like very impressive.
Thanks.
We do have something else planned for you guys, so hopefully you enjoyed this. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and let us
how
know.
How do people subscribe? Do they know how? I didn't know how to do it, so do you press a little thumb? It's a thumb on YouTube.
Go to my page, subscribe. anyways, yeah, we have something fun planned. And yeah, thanks for tuning in. Hopefully you
learned more about the real Nastia Liukin.
Bye.
Bye.